the world. Mr. Resistor here, continuing our alpha journey, and we are in Faction War space. A system currently held by Minmatar. And let's see. What is this nonsense? Okay. I got a new graphics card, and it seems to have caused It seems to have caused Eve to forget some of my settings. And it's kind of annoying. That's just what it's gonna be. It's like folks have been at work here from the that it looks like it's been Amar at work. Alright, so last year, Whisper, I think.
Warp drive active.
Outpost here. Right? It looks like we might be alone in this system.
Warp drive active. drive active.
Okay, so we've got all these marks again. I still don't understand why we didn't have them yesterday. It's weird that there's not a... What is going on here? Is it because it's so low contested? Somebody already was working on it? I don't understand. Like, there's no NPC here, which is weird. And also, it lists the time as, what I mean, it started at 16 minutes, but it was like half through. And also the music is back on. Guess we'll enjoy that for today. Probably turn it off tomorrow. Well, probably turn it off today when I log into my other accounts. Got a friend in system. So that's cool. Got a not friend in system. That's less cool. Our friend is just in a reefer. That's not useful, most likely. Enemy was just passing through. Probably saw two of us in here and decided he didn't want to chance it. Probably could have taken us both out if he wanted to. So anyway, yeah, new video card. So let's bump up the texture quality, shall we? had everything all set up to high, so... We'll see a difference. Oh, I wonder if it was up to 16 because an Amar person was in here trying to cap it. Where is the NPC? Does it trigger us when it shows us Minmatar trying to capture? Need my skilling spree points, right? That's kind of why I'm here. This is starting to get weird. I mean, if we had jumped in and it was unoccupied, there would have been one here already. And then we get another one about every 2.5 minutes, right? So we get a total of 4 throughout the capturing process. Assuming things go normally, at least that's, I guess, what I've seen so far. But now we have 0? I don't understand why. I feel like maybe it's bugged. Not the sort of bug I'm inclined to complain about, since it benefits me, but still, doesn't seem like the correct... It's not the expected behavior, I should say. looks like we got this one without a fight. Five. That's cool.
Warp drive active. Drive active.
That will be nice. Need a fire bonus for the Rifter.
Drive active.
There we go. That's a little more like it. Right. Don't forget to reload. Thank you. Okay. So I think what I'm gonna do after we cap this, assuming we do, and that we survive, is dip into Turner. See what that looks like. Because the Amar just blew up the sun. So that's got to be interesting. I know gates were down, but they seem to be back up. I mean, hopefully I don't get there and then I'm stuck. That'd be unfortunate. Looking at the EVE economic report, looks like production is down significantly. Mining is down a little bit. Mining being down, I suppose, is why ore prices have been good. For a while there, it seemed like I was having trouble selling or when I went out mining. That hasn't been the case lately. Which is unfortunate, because since I started my latest project, I haven't had as much time for mining. Forget to reload. I am intentionally making that my mantra. It's not just to remind you, it's to remind myself also. Okay. Interesting. So I'm looking at, as it was. Changes to security status and abyssals. So as part of the Uprising expansion, we're making some important changes that will largely affect players in HiSec. The goal of these designs is to address the following issues. Griefing of new players and low-value targets, risk versus reward dynamic of abyssal dead space filaments, and shortage of legitimate player targets in high-security space. To achieve these goals, we will be introducing the following new restrictions and limitations. Limit tethering for players with low security status in HiSec. Docking restrictions for outlaws in high security space, changing the security settings for alpha accounts, and removing the option to disable safety, safety red. Updated rule sets for abyssal dead space filament activation. Okay, so let's see. Safety to allow actions with give suspect and criminal or criminal status. Criminal status allows other capsuleers to attack you and will cause Concord to attack you in high security systems for a limited period. Okay, so alpha accounts won't be able to do go full red, I guess, only yellow. Alright, so, continues on. Distinguish between ganking and griefing. Huh, looks like. Okay, so lose security status for attacking people in HiSec. Let's see. It falls below certain thresholds, so it'll be hunted by Empire, Faction, Police, and entering the HiSec system. Any cloaking device fitted to their ship will also be disabled. So they cannot cloak up to avoid faction police. If a player's security status falls below -5, the player becomes an outlaw, allowing anyone to attack them without Concord interference. So taking away the ability to tether, depending on depending on security status of the player in the system. So that's cool. Docking restrictions. Outlaws will no longer be allowed to dock in any structure or station in HiSec space while piloting a ship. Outlaw pilots in capsules, however, will be able to dock, will not be attacked by Empire faction police. It's worth noting, though, that they can still be attacked by other players. Outlaws will be able to undock in a ship, but once undocked, they will be refused docking permission. Alright, well, that's 2 captured. Another 17-5. Alright, so let's go see what Turner looks like.
Warp drive active.
Set our destination back to Resbroco. I don't plan on going all the way back, but one way or another, that'll get us back in Minmatar space where we can dock up. Alright, additional limitations for Alpha pilots in HiSec. Sun A. Can we warp to it?
Warp drive active.
Penalty to scan resolution, penalty to targeting range, penalty to sensor strength, bonus to warp speed. Additional wormhole connections appear within this system. Aw, man. That is weird.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Almost forgot to reload. So anyway, additional limitations for Alpha pilots in high sec. By introducing these changes, the consequences for ganking have become more severe. To avoid players attempting to work around these new rules using Alpha clones, we are preemptively removing the ability for Alpha clones to disable safety while in high security space. They will still be able to enable partial safety in high sec and disable safety completely in any other areas of space. Probably a good idea.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Okay, so the abyssal thing is you can no longer activate filaments in 1.0 or 0.9 security space. Which is fine. I think I've only ever activated them in HEC, which is 0.5, so won't affect me at all, probably. Added suspect flag for high tier abyssals based on security. Tier abyssals in a high security system, you might get a suspect flag. Again, I've only done it in HEC, which is 0.5, but and it looks like T0, T1, T2, and T3 are relatively safe in all systems where they can be launched, so not a big deal for me anyway. I doubt I'll be flying anything on this ship that'll be good enough to even get that high. So I just wanted to check my loyalty point totals real quick. See how that's going. 54,000. Oh, this is only Thuker. Okay. Oh, excuse me. I missed with the mute button. Well, once we get back to a tribal liberation base, I'll have to see what I can actually buy with that. Oh, there's one in system here. Maybe we should do that. Never mind, it's not in this system, it's in the next system. So that's okay.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Still need a bunch of those. Not getting there anytime soon, although that would be cool. Right. Specialization. Customs office gantry. Huh. Uses a whole lot of planetary materials. So what a winter scaffold equipment. Stabilization thrusters, weak gravity, large stationary structures in the orbit of planetary bodies. This model provides the skeletons for an orbital customs office. Right. Well, we're Republic fleet drones. That's cool. So, let's see. Inertia. Twice as tough as T2, so that's cool. So lock is the same, tracking is better than T2. Radius is the same, optimal range is the same. Max velocity, same as T2. Damage modifier is same as T2. Looks like damage profile is the same as T2. Bandwidth should be the same. Okay, so it's a better tracking and twice as much shield, basically. Twice as much armor. Structure. Is slightly less. Okay, structure is the same as T1. Interesting. But I guess the real thing is the price here, right? Like, that's a pretty good payout if I were to bring some in and just use my LP to sell them, right? $3 million. Yeah. Okay. This actually seems like the cheaper way to do it. Get a Rifter Hull, a UUA Nexus chip, and because that's, what, 500? Or is it 5,000? I forget. Anyway, the Nexus chip is relatively cheap versus all the mats for building this. Joel. stabber, 45. Oh, wow. I actually have the LP for this. That's interesting. For a scythe, if I wanted to go missiles, but I have to say, you're into LP or buying stuff with LP to sell. This whole faction warfare thing seems like it's pretty profitable. Do they not? Oh. Huh. They don't sell the UUA chips. So, okay. So I'd have to get one from, like, Boundless. Probably. Which I could then... trade in for the fire tail. Interesting. Fire tail's a pretty fun little ship. I had one for a while on another character. It's good times. Only two guns. Interesting. So wait, what's the bonus? 25% bonus to small projectile turret damage. Okay, well that's why it only needs two guns. Yeah. 10% to small projectile. Interesting. And I thought it had more guns than that, but maybe I'm just remembering wrong. Yambo. No drones. Man, this is loud. Alright. The okay. That seems a little bit better. Anyway, fire tail. We're gonna get one of those sometime in the near future. Well, oh wow, over an hour. So that's gonna be it for today. So until next time, have a good one.